So at this point in my life, I feel like the universe has said, here's a bunch of cool new people to get to know and who might inspire you. You know, life is a journey, and this is the new part of my journey, the next chapter. I feel this fire, this passion that I thought that maybe I had lost, and I'm so grateful for that.
To be able to have no sort of boundaries and make something new is really inspiring to me.
After 18 years, my record deal with RCA came up for renewal, and at that point, I really had a decision to make. I could choose to keep doing things the way that I'd been doing them for the past 18 years, or I could, you know, shake things up a little bit, surround myself with new people, people that see things in a different way, that maybe see me in a different way, and just really start over, start fresh.
Today for Republic Nashville, a dream comes true. Please welcome the newest member of the Big Machine label group on Republic Nashville, Martina McBride.
My heart is beating so fast.
This is the real deal, too.
Well, you're stuck with me now.
Yay.
While I was transitioning into a new record label and new management, I really had a sort of this chunk of time, and I just decided to really focus on writing, on songwriting, and just see what came of it. You know, I felt like it was time to really see if I started writing seriously, what came out of my soul and my heart. I started getting a lot of invitations from songwriters to write with them, and instead of doing what I normally would do, which would just, you know, say, oh, I don't have time for that, or that's not really my thing, and I just decided, you know what, I really owe it to myself. And I think it came at a really good time, you know, with everything being so new and fresh, and just thinking about who you are as an artist and what you want to say for the next 10 years, and you get a clear picture of where you've been, and, you know, just really own that voice instead of waiting for someone else to write what I want to say or what I feel. I just thought it was important to own that.
Blowing cold.
We are on our way to
but
Atlanta.
Our hearts were
to make a record. The recording process for this album was really different than any record I've ever made, and I think the biggest difference was I recorded the record in Atlanta. I've made every other record in Nashville, and somebody had said to me, have you ever thought about making a record outside of Nashville? Sort of get out of your comfort zone. And I thought, no, I haven't really, because, you know, all my responsibilities are here. I've got my family is here, and then I realized that because all my responsibilities are here and it is my home, I spend very little time when I'm making a record. I spend very little time actually making music, and a lot of time getting sort of pulled in every direction. You know, whether it's doing business with a record company or, you know, taking care of my family, and I spend a very little time actually making music or creating or even having the clarity in my mind to even focus on creating something. And I just felt that this record was such a critical record for my career. I just felt like it was really important to see what happened if I could just get up and make music every day.
Hi, okay, thank you. No, in the back.
I've got my wine and my makeup. It came out of a conversation at dinner one night when Borchetta said, how do you feel about riding a train across the country? And I was like, I like trains. I've always wanted to take a train ride. Cool. And like 2.5 months later, there was this huge presentation with all these stops. And, you know, it was like, they really took it and ran with it. And I'm like, awesome. It's going to be great.
I mean, I just feel like people are going to say, why a train? Like, why are you on a train? What's the connection with the actual physical train? You can somehow focus the whole concept of it back to the record, like I said, if it was 11 across America or something that had 11 in it, then I think it becomes, makes more sense.
When I was first approached with this idea of going on a train across the country, I was really intrigued by it because it's so different, and I never really heard of it being done before to launch a record. Normally, when you release a record, you go to New York or LA and you're on television. You go and you sing a song, and then that's really it. The fact that I could step off of the train in 11 different cities across America and see my fans there and really feel like, I really felt like I was kind of hand delivering the record to them, which was such a cool thing for me to really be able to connect.
Well, we
were
smart leaving when we did.
Wow.
I'm so glad.
We barely made the weather, I'll tell you.
When we went to Atlanta, the timing was so weird. We actually ended up going on the day that they had this huge snow and ice storm that literally shut the city down. Like, we couldn't go. If we had wanted to go anywhere else, we couldn't have. I'm just so thankful that our hotel was literally across the parking lot from the studio. If we'd been a few miles away, we would have been stranded there. Our caterers couldn't even get to the studio. I mean, nobody was coming in or out. And then once we were there, there was no place we could go or nothing we could do except just make music all day long. And it was such a blessing, really, I think, looking back, because there were no distractions. We could get up anytime we wanted, make music all day. We ate every meal together. And it just, I think it made the whole thing I don't know, it was just, it was such a great experience, and I think that overflowed into the sound of the music.
I know.
I hear laughing all the time this week. Everybody's laughing and having a good time. Yeah. And it was beautiful.
Well, you're right, it's a great mood.
I met Pat Monahan and Train when we did a TV show together. And we did this song as a duet, which was their single at the time called Marry Me, and it was just magic. And I don't know, there's something about it. It was like when we finished, the room was just kind of silent, and we looked at each other, and I can't remember who said first that I should put that on my album. And I said, well, I would obviously love to. I want you to come sing it with me. And so he came to Atlanta when we tracked it. He came and recorded it with me. First of all, he's one of my favorite singers. Really, just so soulful and such a great singer.
Marry me today and every day. Marry
the entire time you were singing, how amazing it is that 2-3 months ago we hadn't even met, and I've always loved what you do, your singing, and here we are in the studio.
Having him in the studio and being able to sing that song sort of face to face, rather than, you know, sometimes when you do duets, you're not there together. It's such a sweet song, and it was just really great to have him there. I think it inspired the whole band, and I was really happy to put it on my record.
So we're gonna cut your favorite song next.
Teenage Daughters.
No, Always Be This Way.
Oh, okay, sweet. Can you send it to me?
Yeah. I can send you a copy when I'm done.
Mom!
What?
Could we call someone else?
Yes, okay. I'll talk to you guys later.
Love you.
I love you too.
Bye.
Bye.
Love you.
Bye. Bye.
Heartbeat faster, you got me feeling like a sweet disaster.
not good with them. Okay.
That's cool.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You spend 2 or 3 hours on each song, and you don't really have the luxury of, say, for instance, spending a day on a song, because you have the band for a limited amount of time. You work from 10 in the morning, usually until 9 or 10 at night, and you have a finite amount of time to record a certain number of songs. So you want to try to get 2 to 3 songs in a day. We had the luxury of really, really visiting each song until we got it how we wanted it. And songs like Always Be This Way, for example, that song was a little bit tricky. I mean, we worked and worked and worked on how, we changed the key, we changed the tempo, we changed the instrumentation. I mean, it took a lot of work to get it how we wanted it.
Not afraid.
I know. I'm trying to figure out if it's the right key still. Can you hear it again?
Yeah, it's so good.
I just felt really good about the fact that we were able to have time to really, really, really live with these songs and, you know, come back even 2 days later. And it wasn't like we were running out of time. That was really exciting, I think, for all the musicians to just feel that freedom and that sort of no pressure to make the music that we wanted to make.
God, can you hear him yelling? This is awesome.